Siema, witam was bardzo serdecznie w kolejnym odcinku na tym kanale. Z tej strony oczywiście Arket. No i dzisiaj obejrzymy sobie odcinek o wieżowcach. No, tłumacząc to, to jest 15 najbardziej innowacyjnych wieżowców. No i co, oglądamy.
There's a limit to how far cities can expand outwards, and the only solution is to keep building higher and higher. Skyscrapers are now a common.
Okej, będę w sumie tłumaczyć, bo tutaj dodam tylko napisy od 7 minuty, żeby się z montażem zgadzało. No dobra, jeszcze raz przesłucham, bo. Okej, prawie wszędzie gdzie idziesz, spotykasz. No dokładnie, spotykasz wyzwania z designami, czyli pewnie chodzi o te budowle, z projektowaniem nimi. No i nadchodzą do wykonania. No, trochę zbytnio dosłownie, ale dobra. Ok, wieżowiec Aqua z Chicago to jest oczywiście USA.
Chicago, Illinois is one of the most distinctive skyscrapers in the country and brought something new to the skyline of a city renowned for its skyscrapers and structural innovation. Completed in 2009 and designed by architect.
I tutaj jeszcze dodam w sumie podpowiedź, że to głównie będzie o historii tych wieżowców i o budowie, jak się prezentuje, żeby łatwiej się tłumaczyło, to dodam jeszcze. No i tam dodał oczywiście ten rok powstania i tak dalej. No to oczywiście architekci, znaczy, no Aqua to jest ta nazwa tego wieżowca. Okej, to w sumie było wcześniej o tych metrach. To można po prostu cofnąć sobie, mam takie wrażenie. Dobra. A, to pewnie o metry kwadratowe, 6000 łącznie.
It stands out mostly though for its unusual exterior, which features undulating balconies that ripple across it like waves.
Okej, wiele sposobów ma wybudowany ten wieżowiec i posiada również fale, czyli no to jest zrobienie, jak widać. Tego budynku. No i fasada nie jest bardzo estetyczna. To w sumie po prostu widać. Trochę dużo tekstu jest tutaj nawalone w sumie. Jakby trochę sobie AI, ten twórca filmu, chwilę jeszcze zobaczę, jak on się nazywał. Videozone. Jakby sobie trochę dogenerował między tego tekstu. No dobra, oglądam dalej. No exterior to jest, to powiem, w jakimś sensie szerokość i innowacyjność też można do tego w sumie podpiąć. No i outdoor to jest oczywiście poza domem.
Offering something you don't get in many urban high-rises. The floor space is divided between hotels, apartments, condominiums and office spaces.
Office spaces to oczywiście miejsca tam, gdzie można pracować, na przykład w biurze. No i community, społeczność. To jest. Energy efficient lighting to jest. Inaczej to się mówiło. No nie wiem, ze zwojów odnawialnych i to jest, to są źródła światła, z tego light jest. Tak jest. No i zielony sufit, wiadomo.
It's features like this that have earned it a number of awards and has established Gene Gang as a leading figure in contemporary architecture.
I temporary architecture to jest tymczasowa architektura. Tak jest. Okej. Tutaj mamy z Japonii Tokyo Sky Tree. I dosłownie to tłumacząc, powietrzne drzewo.
Tokyo Sky Tree is an iconic symbol of Tokyo that reaches a height of over
2000. Jest ikonicznym symbolem.
Since its completion in May of 2012, the Sky Tree has been a major television and radio broadcast site in the city.
Może transmitować telewizję stąd. Może tutaj turystów.
I ma związane
do kultury i jest ten. No i używany przez Japończyków.
In honor of the historic Musashi Province, which is an area that encompassed Tokyo, Saitama, and part of the Kanagawa Prefecture. This integration of history was part of the tower's design philosophy from the start, aiming to blend traditional Japanese ideas with cutting-edge technology.
Czyli porównując z tradycyjną kulturą, no wiadomo, tego państwa i technologią.
Architecturally speaking, the Tokyo Skytree is
a architecture to już wcześniej tłumaczyłem.
Its exterior is inspired by traditional Japanese architecture, which includes the concepts of sori and mukuri. Curves that look interesting and offer wind resistance.
No to nie od czego jest niestety.
The tree can go up to one of its two observation decks, the highest of which is the Tembo Galleria at 1476 feet.
Okej, to było, no niestety tutaj podane w stopach, więc tego nie przekonwertuję teraz na szybko. Może w montaż jeszcze to dodam.
From these vantage points you can enjoy views of the Tokyo metropolitan area and on clear days even see Mount Fuji on the horizon. The complex also
teraz sporo pauz robię, ale już trudno.
Aquarium, planetarium and numerous restaurants, making it a successful.
O, i są tam restauracje.
Number 13, Hotel Portafira.
Wielokrotne. Chwila, to jest oczywiście nazwa, prawie zapomniałem. Portafira to jest, no z hiszpańskiego wiadomo. Barcelona, Hiszpania. I tam znajduje też się hotel, jak widać.
Okej,
tutaj podał metry. Dobrze. Twórca filmu.
The building's exterior is covered up with a facade that changes in color from deep red
to the shades
of pink at the top.
Z tą fasadą i z, wiadomo, z boczną objętością tych wieżowców. No i no, również ten, tak jak, nie tylko jak w tytule filmu, też to jest pewnie dość przydatne. Jak hotel ma aż tyle pokojów i aż tyle pięter, więc to pewnie jest przydatne.
The dynamism and warmth of the city. The hotel has 320 rooms and suites, each designed with comfort and convenience of guests in mind. The
interior
has state-of-the-art amenities. Floor-to-ceiling windows in the rooms.
I również ma furniture,
allowing you to look out at the city's beauty from the comfort of your own room. Now, apart from the rooms, the Hotel Portafira offers a range of facilities, including a top floor. Or restaurant that provides views too, a wellness center, a meeting spaces equipped for any events, and its location is apart from
the centrum. Wellness center, chyba centrum rekreacji? Nie, na pewno. Ale tak to powiedziałem, to musi tak być.
Its position near the Fira Barcelona Gran Via, which is one of Europe's largest and most important trade fairs and exhibition centers.
Jaki tam był tytuł tego wieżowca? Close to Barcelona's main attractions,
including the famous Las Ramblas, the Gothic Quarter and the Sagrada Familia. Number 12, the Oriental Pearl Tower, Shanghai.
Okej, okay, to oczywiście Chiny, China.
The Pearl Tower is an incredible structure in the bustling Pudong area of China. Operating as a television and radio tower, it's become one of the most recognizable landmarks in Shanghai.
No, czyli jest, gdzie się nadaje telewizja też.
Reaching a height of over 1500 feet or 468 meters, it was China's tallest
468 metrów,
and remains one of the tallest towers in the world. Its design, featuring 11 spheres of various sizes, supported by three columns, draws inspiration from a verse of the Tang Dynasty poem, Pipa Song.
Zaprojektowany, żeby kazał odpowiednie kolory? Nie rozumiem. Aha, że jest w futurystycznym stylu architektonicznym i dobre ma widoki stąd. No to jest legit tutaj. Trochę przedłuża ten twórca filmu, wideo, coś tam.
There's also a revolving restaurant in one of its larger spheres.
No i mają tam muzeum i wiadomo inne cateringi.
Again, offering an experience you won't find anywhere else.
For those wanting to see just how central the experience, czyli there's also the 20 room space hotel. Tylko daję wrażenie trochę za mula na tym, no ale dobra. Dobra, jeszcze to, tylko to jeszcze przetłumaczę. Experience to oczywiście jest doświadczenia lub doświadczenie czegoś. I tutaj w takim kontekście było, że można jakieś przyjemne doświadczenia po prostu w tym wieżowcu. Tak to odpowiednio tłumacząc. Ok, zbliżamy się do 7 minuty. Tutaj Australia, to nie muszę tłumaczyć, to wiadomo. Państwo, Związek Australijski, no ale można się domyśleć oczywiście.
Located in the heart of Melbourne at 318 Russell Street. It was completed in 2015, and with 57 floors, it's one of the tallest residential buildings in the city. Its sleek, elliptical form minimizes wind load and helps to harness natural light. But there's far more to it.
No, czyli to chodzi o te szkła, w sensie okna, żeby naturalne światło tutaj przychodziło. No i jeszcze wcześniej coś tam o roku wspomniał.
First. Designed by the renowned architectural firm Ellenberg Fraser in collaboration with Desenio Australia for its interiors, Abode 318 is certainly visually impressive. It features a series of undulating patterns that create an interplay of light and shadow.
Chwila, zapomniałem tłumaczyć. Patterns to jest oczywiście warstwy, wielokrotnie warstwiony pewnie jest ten budynek i no i cienie, shadows.
A thin layer of rose-colored glass. Something that also helps to insulate the structure. Reaching to a height of
187
meters, there's 450 apartments, along with a range of amenities that are available.
No i wiadomo, ten zasięg. Zasięg horyzontalny tego budynku. No i dobra, to przejdźmy już do następnej sekwencji tego filmu. Myślę, że coś tam dodam jeszcze do montażu. Trochę jednak za mało wytłumaczyłem. Słowo mi to nie wyszło na pewno, no ale... No myślę, że większość tego jest teraz już zrozumiała. To jest po prostu zwykły informacyjny film. No i dobra, w tej części już będą napisy. Które już dodam później, bez mojego komentarza. W sensie będzie mój komentarz, ale napisy już nie będę tłumaczyć każdego słowa o słowo. I lecimy dalej.
The inclusion of other communal spaces, such as a lounge and dining area, encourages a sense of community and interaction among residents, making the building more than just a place to live, but a place to belong. Each unit is finished with high-quality materials and features state-of-the-art appliances.
Ładnie, że to tłumaczy.
The highest standards of urban living. Being both a landmark and an important provision of residential space, Abode 318 is an example of how cities can continue to adapt to cater to changing requirements, and it's likely more will be built across Australia in the coming years. Number 10. Absolute World Towers, Mississauga, Canada. The Absolute World Towers, which are often called the Marilyn Monroe Towers by locals because of their curvaceous hourglass figures, are twin residential skyscrapers in Mississauga, Canada. Completed in 2011 and 2012, Towers 1 and 2 reach heights of 587 feet or 179 meters and 518 feet or 158 meters.
Ten znak wodny ma nietypowy, taki trochę przeduży.
Landmark visible from miles.
No, nie wygląda najgorzej w sumie.
International design competition won by MAD Architects, a Beijing-based firm known for its forward-thinking approach and willingness to challenge conventional norms. The design's most noticeable feature is its organic fluid form, which sees each floor rotated slightly from the one below it, giving the towers a spiraling effect.
Okej, to było dość chmurowo. Murzyście. Nieźle gadam dzisiaj.
Inside, the towers have luxurious amenities, including state-of-the-art fitness centers, indoor-outdoor swimming pools, and a spacious entertainment space. The interior design continues the themes from the exterior with high-end finishes and a luxurious
Coś śmiesznego się przypomniało.
Beyond their architectural innovation, they're part of the larger complex known as Absolute City Center, which includes additional residential towers and facilities designed to create a vibrant community-oriented space. The towers have received numerous prestigious awards, including the Empora Skyscraper Award, signifying their importance to modern architecture and how structures like these can rejuvenate the urban areas around them.
No nieźle to wygląda, jak mówiłem.
Taipei 101, once the tallest building in the world when it was finished in 2004, reaches a height of 1667 feet or
500 meters
as it dominates the skyline of Taipei.
Widziałem to co najmniej parę razy na zdjęciach.
The design of it is deeply symbolic, incorporating elements of traditional Chinese architecture alongside modern design principles that reflects Taiwan's blend of the traditional and the contemporary. Its postmodernist architectural style, designed by C.Y. Lee and partners, is inspired by a bamboo star,
no, ciekawe, dość.
A symbol of strength and resilience in Chinese culture. The tower is made up of 8 segments, with 8 being a number associated with prosperity in Chinese culture, each of which is stacked on top of one another and contains 8 floors. This numerical symbolism is integral to the building's identity, which is located on the 89th to 91st floors, offers visitors views of Taipei and its surrounding mountains, making it a must-visit destination for tourists. Taipei 101 is also renowned for its commitment to sustainability. In 2011, it was awarded the Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design Platinum certification, becoming the tallest and largest green building in the world at the time. This achievement was a result of Taiwan's dedication to environmental conservation and sustainable development, which has led to the skyscraper acting as a blueprint for newer designs looking to incorporate the same principles. Number 8, 432 Park Avenue, New York.
Okay, tam szczegółowo było dość.
Is a noticeable part of the busy New York skyline. Is one of the
według mnie za dużo słów nawarstwione to jest trochę.
Completed in 2015, it reaches a height of 1,396 feet, or 426 meters, which makes it one of the tallest residences.
Oczywiście nie w takim sensie, że jest szybko, tylko po prostu za dużo jest porównań podobnych, porównań i formy zdań. Dość niewiele różniących się.
Myślę,
że to jest celowy zabieg, że tak mocno formalnie to brzmiało na tym filmie.
Including iconic landmarks such as Central Park, the Empire State Building, and beyond. The building's grid-like facade is not only what makes it recognizable, but also adds to its structural stability, and it helps it to withstand the strong winds that pound skyscrapers of such
heights. Ciężko na ten Dailymotion, także tylko używają Full HD. To kolejny film, który się natknęłem tutaj na 720p. Czyli wiadomo, to jest jeszcze mniej niż 1980x 1080.
Outdoor terrace, 75-foot indoor swimming pool, fitness center, and
spa.
The attention to detail and quality within each residence and the building's communal spaces reflects a commitment to providing unparalleled living experiences. Now, beyond what it directly offers, 432 Park has also sparked conversations about how the skyline of New
York and
super tall residential buildings will affect the city. It proved that there is a demand for high-end living spaces in the sky, which is a trend that's been replicated in cities around the globe as a way to enable growth without expanding the geographic footprint. Moving on to number 7, 30 St. Mary's.
Aha, teraz w ogóle się coś dowiedziałem. Zresztą większość filmów nie jest jego, bo też tutaj byli tagowani użytkownicy.
Completed in May of 2004, it was designed by Norman Foster.
Kilka kanałów YouTube już się wyświetliło tutaj.
First, with a conservative approach to tall buildings in the city, it stands at 590.
No przynajmniej nie muszę ich tagować dodatkowo, tylko po prostu dodam link do tego filmu.
The design is undeniably unique because of its distinctive curved glass facade, which minimizes wind deflections and creates a unique optical illusion. The aerodynamic shape isn't just for aesthetics; it plays a significant role in reducing the building's energy consumption. The structure is encased in 260,000 square feet or 24,000 square meters of glass, but it manages to be remarkably energy efficient. Sustainability was a core principle design of the Gherkin, and to keep this, it features a double glazing system with a gap between the panes that acts as an insulator, reducing the need for air conditioning and heating. As well as being ambitious itself, the Gherkin marked a significant shift from traditional seamlessly with the city's historical backdrop. The building's unique shape and its environmentally conscious design have now made it a favorite among architects, residents, and tourists. Internally, it's just as impressive, housing offices, a bar, and a restaurant on top of its floors, offering panoramic views of London. It's also won numerous awards for its architectural elegance and
environment. The Royal
Institute of British Architects Stirling Prize in 2004. Number 6, Alhambra Tower, Kuwait. Since being completed in 2011, the Alhambra Tower has been a standout feature on the skyline of Kuwait. Designed by the renowned architectural firms Skidmore, Owings, and Merrill, it reaches a maximum height of 1,358 feet or 414 meters, making it one of the tallest in the world. What it makes it unusual is its asymmetrical form, which culminates in a flare.
No, jest drabaczny chmur dosłownie.
Middle Eastern cloak swirling in the wind. This design not only offers a visual spectacle, but also serves practical purposes, as the tower's facade is made up of a series of vertical limestone ribs, which shade the building from the scorching sun, significantly reducing cooling costs. This innovative approach to climate control is a perfect example of how modern architecture can adapt to and incorporate traditional strategies. The south wall of the Alhambra Tower is covered in glass, maximizing natural daylight and providing breathtaking views of the Arabian Gulf. Inside, the tower has a luxurious five-story shopping mall at the base, offering a blend of high-end retail, dining, and entertainment. And above the
engineering
feats involved in constructing it are impressive too. Its core, which
has
staircases, shifts position as the building rises, which is a technique that enhances its stability and resistance to wind. This core, combined with the ingenious facade and the tapered design, represents an advancement in skyscraper tech, and it's now incorporated in most new designs. Far from simply being a commercial
telephone,
the tower reflects Kuwait's
interest.
The tower's lobby is decorated with artworks that celebrate Kuwaiti and Islamic art, contributing to the building's identity as a space where commerce, culture, and art are combined. Number 5. Lotte World Tower. South Korea has developed hugely in recent decades as an economic and design powerhouse, and its buildings
like the
World Tower that stand as
visual representations of this.
Officially completed in April of 2017, it reaches a height of 1,822 feet, or 555 meters, making it the sixth tallest building in the world, and the first in the country with more than 100 floors. Designed by the architecture firm Cohn Peterson Fox Associates, the tower features a sleek, tapered appearance that's inspired by traditional Korean pottery and brush art. This choice not only pays tribute to Korea's rich cultural heritage, but also represents the country's rise as a global powerhouse.
Teraz ogólnie z tymi rysunkami. No chociaż w sumie to jakiś ten związek pewnie z tym ma.
As well as being an office building, it's virtually a vertical city that offers a wide range of amenities and attractions. Its 123 floors are home to luxury residences, a 7-star hotel, business offices, retail space, and the Seoul Sky Observatory, which offers visitors views of the city below from one of the world's highest observation decks. If you visit, the glass-floored observation deck is a must-see, providing a thrilling experience for visitors as they gaze down to the ground at 1,640 feet up. The building's base is connected to Lotte World Mall and the Lotte World Theme Park, further ensuring the tower's role as a centerpiece of entertainment and commercial activity in Seoul. Number 4, the HSB Turning Torso, Malmö, Sweden. The Turning Torso is an impressive skyscraper in Malmö in Sweden, which was completed in 2005.
It's 623
feet or 190 meters, making it the tallest building in Sweden. Inspired by a twisting human form, this design is the brainchild of Spanish architect Santiago Calatrava, who's based a concept on one of his
own sculptures. It's an
embodiment of the blend of artistic vision and architectural functionality, symbolizing a forward-thinking approach to living spaces in the 21st century. The structure is made up of 9 cubes that are twisted around a vertical
spiraling
effect. This unique design doesn't just provide aesthetic interest, but it also went against the grain in the construction method.
Jakiś most tutaj do przechodzenia na wejściu jest, albo się pod ziemią wchodzi po prostu. Z tej perspektywy nie widać żadnego wejścia. O, a teraz jest. Okej.
Okay. Constructed primarily from concrete and steel, the Turning Torso is divided into 54 stories, housing 147 apartments that offer views out across the Øresund Strait and beyond.
The building
includes office spaces, conference rooms, making it a multifunctional structure, with interiors that reflect Calatrava's artistic flair. The Turning Torso has gone on to receive international acclaim, earning a number of awards for its architectural innovation and becoming a symbol of Malmö's Renaissance. The city, once known for its industrial landscape, has been transformed into a hub of creativity and sustainability, with the Turning Torso at the center. Number 3, Canton Tower, Guangzhou, China.
Canton Tower, which is officially known as Guangzhou Sightseeing Tower, is in the Haishu District and was completed in 2010. Designed by the Dutch architects Mark Hemmel and Barbara Kuit of Information-Based Architecture, along with the engineering consultancy Arup, the tower reaches a height of 1,968 feet or 600 meters, making it one of the tallest structures in
China. Szarowe mają w tym dniu.
The design of the Canton Tower took a different approach than traditional tower architecture, featuring what's described as a hyperboloid structure derived from the geometric rotation of an ellipse along an
axis. Tak dużo chmur nie ma. Nietypowo.
Has been likened to the figure of a woman, earning it the affectionate nickname Xiaomanyao, which translates to slim waist. The facade is a combination of engineering and aesthetics, with an LED lighting system that illuminates the skyline with vibrant colors and patterns. The exterior also features a double helix staircase known as the Spider Walk, which spirals around the structure itself. Inside, it's got a range of attractions and amenities, of course, including observation decks, a revolving restaurant, conference facilities, and entertainment venues. The observation decks provide incredible views, offering sights across the bustling cityscape. For thrill seekers, the tower also offers the Sky Drop, which is a ride that holds the record for the highest vertical freefall in the world.
No, wciąż tutaj dużo kolorów.
Circles the top of the tower, providing a unique perspective.
A w sumie. Po co mieć? W sumie jeden dobry kolor. Kolory, jak można mieć wszystkie, tak jak na przykład na tęczy.
Canton Tower is by far one of the most important towers in China, and one.
I też widzę, że często na tych wieżach na samym górze jest. No przeważnie w tych najwyższych.
Of all the new residential skyscrapers that have
recently been,
there's one that stands out the most for its design, location, and functionality. Known as Central Park Tower, it's on Billionaires Row along West 57th Street, and completed in 2020, it's the tallest residential building in the world, reaching an incredible height of 1,550 feet, or 472 meters.
W sumie jeszcze nie tak dawno temu sobie krzesło gamingowe kupiłem. Jest zarąbiste, przynajmniej są bardziej jakieś sensowne, podobne do fotela.
The tower's facade, made up of glass and steel, offers unobstructed panoramic views. Its surprisingly slender profile not only adds to the building's visual appeal, but also addresses the practical challenges of constructing a super tall skyscraper in the heart of Manhattan, such as wind resistance and structural stability. The tower's design incorporates state-of-the-art wind management features, ensuring comfort for its residents amid the challenges posed by such heights. The interiors are designed with a next-level attention to detail, featuring high ceilings, top-of-the-line finishes, and expansive layouts, offering an experience that's both opulent and comfortable. As a result, Central Park Tower is a statement of prestige, offering facilities that cater to every conceivable luxury, including a private club, an outdoor terrace, a swimming pool, and a fitness center. Beyond the residential units, the building includes Nordstrom's first full-line department store in New York City at its base, spanning several floors and providing a high-end retail experience. This combination of residential and commercial spaces is an important part of modern urban developments, making them relevant to the local community at ground level. Number 1. The Burj Khalifa, Dubai.
So the Burj Khalifa
is the most
architecturally impressive building on the planet. Required
a whole new approach to construction to even.
No, dobra, niech się nie będzie.
Since its completion in 2010, it's held the title of the tallest building
in the world.
2,717 feet, or 828 meters. It also acts as a symbol of Dubai's meteoric rise on the global stage. It's such a feat of engineering that, despite attempts elsewhere, there's no sign of it losing its records anytime soon. Designed by the architectural firm Skidmore, Owings & Merrill LLP, the Burj Khalifa's shape draws inspiration from the symmetrical structure
of the Hayat Flower,
integrating aspects of Islamic architecture in a modern
ciekawa pora dnia do takich zdjęć.
Land maximizes views of the Arabian Gulf and supports the structural stability. And the building's exterior is clad in reflective glazing, studded with aluminum and stainless steel.
Czy tam rękę podniósł? To jest.
Constructing it was a monumental
challenge. Aha,
posed by going to such unprecedented heights. The tower's core is made of high-performance concrete, which is further reinforced with steel to withstand the wind.
Też fajnie od słońca to się odbija, widzę. W każdym razie,
which supports the building's weight and gives it strength and stability.
With 163 floors and more than 3.3 million square feet, the Burj Khalifa is a mixed-use development that includes residential apartments, corporate offices, the Armani Hotel, and observation decks that offers views.
To też rzeka była? To też ciekawe.
The observation decks on the 124th, 25th, and 148th floors are among the tower's most popular attractions, offering vistas that stretch out onto the horizon.
No nieźle to wygląda, mimo wszystko. Tutaj wszyscy. Immediately draws eyes towards the city, and the Burj Khalifa. Jak widzicie, widzowie.
It made it a world destination, and now with millions of visitors each year, it's proven to be more than worth the estimated $1.5 billion cost. Thanks for watching, everyone. I'll see you next time.
No i to by było tyle w tym odcinku. Tutaj już, no koniec. Nic więcej tutaj już nie będzie. Dobra, w poprzednim odcinku zapomniałem ocenić poprzednich. No ale tutaj już mogę dać, bo już teraz na świeżo pamiętam. Jaki okej materiał. Taki mógł być lepiej, no ale jakieś bardzo dobrą ocenę nie zasługuje. Ale niech będzie, trochę naciągana, ale dam lajka. Nieźle. No i też niestety na Dailymotion nie ma sekcji komentarzy, to nic nie mogę zostawić przy tym. No raczej będzie wiedział, że mam lajkę dałem. Dobra. To byłoby na tyle w tym odcinku. No to na razie. Zobaczymy, jak szybko mi się uda następny wrzucić.